Good and Mad is filled with stories of women that, even having written about them, I wish I knew more about. It's remarkable to me that somebody like Rose Schneiderman isn't somebody everybody's taught about in schools. She gives an incredible speech in 1911 after the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory, which killed 146 people, most of them young women workers, a furious speech about the passivity of those around her and how we need a working people's movement. Rose Schneiderman goes on later in her life to write the workplace safety regulations that in many cases are still the regulations that are in place today, more than 100 years later. There are other stories that we think are familiar to us. Rosa Parks' story of refusing to give up her seat on the Montgomery bus in 1955, which of course prompted the Montgomery bus boycott. We're taught a version of Rosa Parks that is very demure, that is tired and exhausted. We're not taught about the Rosa Parks who was a furious fighter against sexual assault, against racial inequality, who committed a political, active, and angry act in refusing to give up her seat, and who had been working politically and out of a kind of fury at inequality for her entire life. That same year was the murder of Emmett Till. And we are taught about Mamie Till, his grieving mother, but often the images of Mamie Till are of her weeping and having to be held up next to her son's coffin. We know about Mamie Till and we know about Emmett Till, and we know that that too was another catalytic moment in what would become the civil rights movement. But we're never taught that it must have been anger, and not just grief, not just mourning, but raw fury that prompted a mother to fight to have that boy's body brought back to Chicago, exposed to her and then to the world, to make visible the kind of violent injustice that she had to live with individually. I'm writing this book about the transformative power of women's anger, looking to past figures from Mamie Till and Rosa Parks and Rose Schneiderman. And then in front of me on the television screen is the activism of the kids from Parkland, Florida in the wake of the mass shooting in their high school. Young Emma Gonzalez, a teenager, who is getting up in front of the world and saying things like, "We call BS," and embarking on a fight for better gun safety laws. And I'm looking at this young woman and thinking, you are part of this story that has roots going back centuries, and part of how this country is gonna be remade is in your hands.